Could BMW be about to kill off the M3 and the M4? Now that sounds impossible, but it's just revealed a brand new car that could be quicker and cheaper than those famous sporting models. It's called the i4 M50, and I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about it and explain why it might make you cancel your M3 or M4 order. Anyway, I'm Matt Watson, and you're watching Car Wow. Buying a new car? Then head to Car Wow, and my team will help you find your next car at a fair price. Car Wow, your one-stop car buying comparison site. The latest BMW M3 and M4 are both brand new cars. They were only revealed in 2020. So how can they possibly be in danger of being replaced already? Is there something wrong with them? Well, no, definitely not. They're both great sporting cars. Well, if you don't mind staring at that huge grille. One of the reasons they're so good is their new engine. It's called the S58, and it's a 3-litre twin-turbo straight six. A bit like the one in the old M3 and M4, to be fair. However, it's much more powerful than the engine in those cars. The old M3 competition made 450 horsepower, but the new one makes 510 horsepower. And it delivers all its power with almost zero turbo lag. It just feels so responsive. But you know what's even more responsive than a well-tuned engine? An electric motor. And that's exactly what BMW has fitted to the new i4 M50, which is the car that could be about to accidentally kill off the M3 and the M4. The i4 M50 isn't just any old electric vehicle. It's the first electric car that's been developed by BMW's M division. It's based on the normal i4, which is a sort of electric version of the brand new BMW 4 Series Grand Coupe. In fact, the regular i4 and that new version of the 4 Series look almost exactly the same from most angles. They have the same low roof line, similar bumpers, and yes, they have the same massive rabbit tooth grille. But the i4 is completely different underneath its skin. It has an 80 kilowatt hour battery and a 340 horsepower electric motor instead of a petrol or diesel engine like the 4 Series Grand Coupe. This means you get around 370 miles of range and it'll do 0 to 60 miles an hour in about 5.7 seconds. That's pretty nippy for a fairly normal electric car, but I'm more interested in the i4 M50 version. This has two electric motors instead of one. So there's a 258 horsepower electric motor at the front to drive the front wheels and a 313 horsepower motor at the back to drive the rear wheels. In total, they make 544 horsepower, which is about 34 horsepower more than you get from an M3 or M4 competition. But what's even more impressive is the torque. The new i40 M50's electric motors make 795 newton meters of the stuff, which is 145 newton meters more than you get in the normal petrol powered M cars. This means the i4 M50 is seriously quick. It'll do 0 to 60 miles an hour in 3.9 seconds. So how does that compare with BMW's petrol powered cars? Well, the latest M3 and M4 competition come with a new 8-speed torque converter automatic gearbox. This means they're much easier to launch than the old models, which had dual clutch gearboxes. Now, those models will do 0 to 60 in 3.9 seconds without any fuss, which is exactly the same time as the i4 M50. So that means BMW's first ever M-Performance electric car is just as quick as one of the most famous sports saloons of all time. Although, I've actually timed an M3 from 0 to 60, and it was a lot quicker than BMW claimed. And if you want to see my time with that car, then watch my in-depth video where I test it against an Audi RS4. There's a banner popping out in the top right-hand corner of the screen, which you can click on to go watch that video or follow the link in the description below. If not, stay with me, because this isn't the only time BMW has lied about a car's acceleration. The same thing happened to me when I tested the X6 M competition and the latest M5 competition. Both of these cars were quicker than BMW said they should be. And you know what that means? Yep. The i4 M50 will probably be quicker than its claim figure too. I know what you're thinking, what about the new four-wheel drive M3 and M4? Well yes, BMW has just revealed four-wheel drive versions of those cars for the first time ever. These have the same 510 horsepower as the regular competition models, but they'll be quicker off the line because their extra traction means they can put their power down better when they launch. BMW says both of these four-wheel drive versions can do 0 to 60 miles an hour in 3.5 seconds, which is quicker than the i4 M50. But there's another important thing you have to consider, and that's the price. An entry-level M3 competition costs almost £75,000, and a four-wheel drive version will set you back £77,000. That's about twice the price of an entry-level 3 Series, and that's before you've added any optional extras. And you know how expensive BMW's options can be? You see, if you want to save money on a new BMW 3 Series, I've actually found a great deal on one through CarWow. I'm not going to tell you how much you can save, but if you click on the pop-out banner in the top right-hand corner of the screen, you can watch my review of that car and compare the very latest offers on all versions of the 3 Series. Anyway, you'd think that the new i4 M50 would be even more expensive than an M3. After all, electric versions of normal petrol and diesel-powered cars tend to be a bit pricier. But soon you'll be able to buy a new i4 M50 for less than £64,000. So it's around £11,000 less than a normal M3 competition and £13,000 less than a four-wheel drive version of the M3 competition, which is a bit insane. And that's before you factor in running costs. After all, the M3's 510 horsepower straight six isn't exactly designed for hypermiling, is it? BMW reckons you'll get about 28 miles per gallon out of it. But the i4 M50 is an electric car, which means it'll cost pennies to run if you charge it on a cheap tariff overnight. But that's not all, because BMW's M division probably won't stop with this new M50 model. After all, they love making cars faster. Special edition versions of normal M cars like the M5 CS. An example. So there's a chance there could be an even quicker version of the i40 M50 later. Maybe it'll be called the i40 M50 competition. This is nonsense. Maybe it'll just be called the i4M. In fact, BMW has confirmed it's been testing a prototype electric car that uses three motors instead of just two, like the i4 M50. Okay, so this prototype is actually based on a 5 series, but it's possible BMW could re-engineer the i4 to fit these three electric motors. And if it does, that car will be seriously quick. The most powerful M car at the moment is the M5 CS, which has 635 horsepower, but the three motors in BMW's new prototype produce more than 720 horsepower. Unfortunately, BMW wouldn't say how quick this car was, but it did reveal that it goes from 0 to 60 miles an hour in comfortably less than 3 seconds. Now that's a lot quicker than the latest M3 and M4, even those with all-wheel drive. But what could an i4M with three electric motors look like? Well, the current i4 M50 looks pretty similar to the M Sport versions of the normal 4 Series Grand Coupe, so an even faster version could end up looking pretty similar to the current M4. It might even look a bit like this image we've had rendered. This has the same basic front bumper as an M4, but the rest of the body has the same proportions as a normal i4. It could get larger alloy wheels and wider arches like all M cars do. And BMW might even make that blue hockey stick you get in an i4 the same colour as the M badge. You never know. But what do you think? Would the cheaper i4 M50 tempt you away from a BMW M3 or M4? Or maybe you think BMW's M division should stick to making petrol sports cars? Or are you waiting for BMW to release a 750 horsepower EV? Let me know in the comments below. Hey, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Also, let me know of any other videos you'd like me to do in the comments below. If you click there, you can watch some more videos. And if you click on that box there, you can actually sign up to the CarWow newsletter, where we'll keep you up to date of all the latest news and reviews from the car world in between these video uploads. So just click on that, sign up, it's completely free. And of course, you can cancel anytime you want to. Thanks for watching.